We shipped the first Hydra in April of 2018. We were able to take the lessons from Hydra and apply them to Iris. From Hydra to Iris, we've made improvements in all aspects. So we have all the performance improvements and enhancements in our algorithms and in our overall design for stability in manufacturing and high volume production as well. On all fronts, Iris is a stepwise improvement on the core technology that we've developed. So right now, Iris is exactly on schedule. Actually, some of the engineering validation is ahead of schedule. We've been on schedule with all of our deliverables and milestones with our partners to date. At Volvo, our Iris sensor has been integrated into the vehicle. Their program with the integration of Iris is on schedule.
The progress we've made on Iris in the last, 18 months has been unbelievable. We've gone from concept of an amazing product to actually building our first A samples and B samples, shipping them to our customers and getting amazing feedback. Literally bringing up the capability of building this auto-grade product on a very aggressive schedule and really proving that we can do it.
Hitting auto-grade specs is a non-trivial issue. Over the last quarter, we've been able to execute our engineering validation and prove that our sensor can meet the automotive requirements and the specifications needed for autonomous driving. Based on our simulations and our design and our rigorous engineering process, we knew what our performance would be even before we tested the sensor. We proved that from minus 40C to 85C, the sensor would work exactly as designed. So we put the sensor through an extreme amount of testing for vibration and shock through our design validation process. Right from our first test, Iris has met those specs as well by design.
We at Luminar, we're blessed with having the resources to truly invest in the key technologies that enable our product to be different. We have expertise in-house that are literally developing the processes that it takes to make the units, right along with the engineers that are developing them, from concept through high volume production with one team. So we then have that expertise and we can then transfer it to different partners at different regions around the world. Our first partner is in North America, it's in Mexico. So we'll be able to transfer that knowledge. Meanwhile, we retain that expertise that if a different partner at another region of the world, whether it be Europe or Asia, we can also transfer it to them as well. We're in the process today of transferring that product throughout the global supply chain, where we're partnering with amazing partners who are able to help us go from building, hundreds to building millions as we go forward. Once you have the product designed and the automation set in place, there's nothing holding you back from mass producing it on one line to two lines to 10 lines, from one site to two sites to 10 sites.
By the end of the year, we'll have gone through our production validation phase and prepared ourselves to execute mass production. It's a, huge amount of growth, not just for the technology itself, but for the company. And when you start to see it come to life and you start to see the fruits of the labor that have been put in for years begin to shine, it's an amazing feeling. That's where we're at with Iris right now. We're seeing the performance of the system that's going to enable this new experience, and it's extremely exciting.